Desus and Mero are here, not a moment too soon. And we got to get right to this. Bronx-based, steeped deeply in New York. But you're having the Southern California experience.
Loving it.
What is this about the salad place?
Oh, listen, I'm getting used to L.A. I'm going to Sweetgreen. You don't know cash. Yes. Leaving the house with no cash in my pockets.
Right. You pay with
living that L.A. life. No,
you pay with vibes.
They're like, do you want a bag? And I'm like, oh, God,
no.
You're offended. Yeah.
So this is a great story. It proves my point always that talent tells, the cream will rise. You guys knew each other as kids.
Yes.
Then in real life, you're working for Black Enterprise,
which
Real Magazine. I've seen it. The
Real
newsstand
Magazine, members. Small Business Reporter.
Right. Mm-hmm. But you were saying that sometimes
it was soul-crushing hell. But,
okay.
You know.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. In effect, you were a teacher's aide.
Yeah, and but it wasn't soul-crushing hell, you know, because I love the children and helping them.
Yeah.
But it was, you know, it's a little.
You weren't living up to your potential.
And it's a little jarring to have a kid, 11-year-old, ask you to fillet them.
Right. Yeah. So the two of you are going doing a podcast. Griping about your jobs.
Griping about our jobs. We were griping about our jobs on social media, but the podcast was more about pop culture,
everything,
whatever was going on,
right,
from a Bronx point of view, and people really gravitated towards it.
All right, so the Bodega Boys. Okay, MTV, Viceland, and now finally the Moneylands and Showtime. So premium cable, I think that's a better, much better an envelope is it than Viceland?
It's
a Godfather wedding envelope.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
Right.
It's
okay.
But now this is the dilemma. Does that change you?
No.
No.
Because you know what? It makes our lives easier, so we're less stressed. We have less stress, so we're fine.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
And as we had the conversation beforehand, I have four children, so I will stay broke forever.
Ever. Yes. No. You and me both. Yeah. And, I've been here for 100 years, and paycheck to paycheck. Let's talk about this. we're going to show a clip.
Okay.
Which I think is very funny. And who's the gal? She sounds like the sidekick off camera.
Shout out to Julia Young.
Julia Young.
You know what I'm saying? We've been with her since 4 years.
All right. So are they knowledgeable about Hollywood actresses? Not necessarily.
We're trying.
We're working.
And then you bump into famous people that you don't know are famous because they're outside of your cultural bubble.
Mm-hmm.
You know
what I'm saying? Like a Jessica Chastain.
Exactly.
The name sounds familiar. What show?
She was in Sicario. She was like the main agent of Sicario.
That's Emily Blunt.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Let's be real. Put Emily Blunt next to Jessica Chastain and tell me the difference. Look at that, man. Come on, man.
That's a different color hair, bro.
She went to CVS and got the L'Oreal. She's like, I'm Jessica now.
Emily Blunt was in The Quiet Place.
Is that Bird Box?
It's not Bird Box.
You guys need to get better steeped in white culture. Come on.
We're trying.
What's
going
on?
We're trying.
Baby steps.
We're doing Duolingo class of white culture.
All right. If you guys want, I will provide white tutorials.
Sam, yeah.
Please.
Yes.
Thank you.
I'm having to do it. Ready to go.
Oh, my God.
Help us be our best selves.
Talk to us. That's very funny. Talk to us about the live show, Ace Hotel.
Boom. Ace Hotel. Tomorrow night. We had it yesterday. It was wild. Line around the block. Celebrities in the building.
Absolutely.
People are crying. People are like passing out. Like a Michael Jackson concert.
Yeah, it was
doing
wild.
It again tomorrow. Ace Hotel, all new material.
Listen,
if
you've never seen the Beatles live, this is like 10 times
closer
better.
To it.
Closer to it.
Do you guys riff it or it's routines or
all
what's
riff.
Riffs.
All
really?
Riffs.
A lot of crowd.
You don't have a plan. No.
No plans.
No plan.
Nothing, no written topics.
That's what makes
you have
it so
to
fun.
See our publicists and like all our PR people.
They're just
backstage,
like,
just the backstage, like, what's going on? This night, you ruined it all.
Wait, none of that in California now. Yeah.
No, they're still doing that now. They're breaking the law.
The audience too. Or
oh yeah, it's a lot of crowd work. Because shout out to the Bodega Hive, that's our fan base, and we've never come to LA before, so they're so amped and they're like yelling stuff, and they kind of direct the show.
They've literally been waiting years.
Yeah.
For this, so it's like wow.
People are coming through and they're pregnant, like touch the belly and all. It's a
wow. So essentially. All of us spend a lot of time talking about stars. You guys are stars.
Yes.
I mean, yeah,
yes.
Okay.
We are the biggest thing.
If you say so, yeah.
James Dean.
Yeah. Right.
Yes.
But how? And you like that?
It's weird because we still are getting used to it, so we don't know. We forget.
Are you
famous.
Ready to Uber from your crib in the Hollywood Hills to Sweetgreens?
By helicopter.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
You know what? We're New Yorkers, so we're doing that weirdo thing in LA. We're still walking everywhere.
Yeah.
Right, good.
So people are looking at us like, don't you have a show? Why are you walking?
What are you doing? And Uber is 10 cents.
Right.
So as soon as we start Ubering everywhere, then you know we're ready for LA.
Right.
Uber XL.
You can stream episodes of Desus Mero on Showtime now. Mm-hmm. Catch them live. Ace Hotel down. I might go.
Come too.
I would like to go.
Out.
I think I might go. Tickets.
Come here.
Visit bodegahive.com. Ace is a great place to see folks.
Oh, yeah.
Good to meet you.
Yeah, it's so nice to meet you guys.
Thanks for having us.
Congratulations on everything.
Thank you.